Expectation values in quantum mechanics are an important tool which help us to mathematically describe measurements of quantum systems. You can think of expectation values as the average of all possible outcomes of a measurement, weighted by their respective probabilities. Contrary to what the name suggests, this is not the most probable result of a measurement that you could expect after performing that measurement. To see this, imagine an operator with eigenvalues plus and minus 1. If we assume that both results appear with equal probabilities, then the expectation value of this operator will be 1 half times plus 1 plus 1 half times minus 1. This gives 0, so the expectation value is not even a possible outcome of the measurement and cannot be seen as the most probable result. Let us now talk about how we actually calculate expectation values in quantum mechanics. If we have a quantum system that is described by the wave function psi, then the expectation value of the operator A is defined like this. If we work in the position basis, where the wave function is given by projecting the ket state psi onto the position basis, we can also write down the expectation value of A using an integral like this. Note that it is important that the operator stands between the two wave functions. This is important, for instance, if the operator contains a derivative. There are two more ways to calculate the expectation value of this operator. First, we can make use of the spectral decomposition of A, where the operator can be written as a sum over its eigenvalues Ai times projection operators onto its eigenstates. By using this decomposition in the definition of the expectation value, we get this result. And this is actually very close to the definition we gave at the beginning of this video. We sum over all eigenvalues, which are the possible outcomes of our measurement, weighted by the probabilities that this particular eigenvalue occurs if we start in the state psi. Note that the expression phi I psi is usually called a transition amplitude, and the absolute square of the transition amplitude is called the transition probability. Second, if we use the density matrix formalism, where rho is given as psi psi, we can calculate the expectation value of A by taking the trace over rho times A. In quantum mechanics, taking the trace over an operator means to sum over matrix elements of that operator between states of a complete basis. If we do this, we get an expression containing two complex numbers, which we can move around if we wanted to, since they are not operators. After doing that, we can perform the sum over the basis states, and since they belong to a complete basis, they give us the identity operator. Therefore, we get psi A psi, which means that we get the same result from working with density matrices. And that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching.